Dinner was announced soon after that, and we crossed the hall into a plainly furnished dining room in the rear, the only original feature of which consisted in its being illuminated by a huge crystal ball hanging above the table, which diffused a soft yet powerful light throughout the room. My host indicated a chair opposite him, and we were soon giving our best attention to a dinner served by sake with incredible dexterity, and equal in quality to that of the best Parisian restaurants. I began to feel an increased respect for the doctor. While he might throw his money away upon scientific dawdlings, he at least appreciated the value of a good cook. As sake filled my glass with rare and costly vintages, my awkwardness vanished, and in its place came a gratified sense of my own importance and of extreme good nature toward the worthy doctor who was taking so much trouble upon my account. Here in the rear room, beneath the subdued radiance of the crystal ball, one could hear no sound from the outside world. It was as if we were immured in some palace dungeon far below the surface of the earth. I remember that at the time I dimly recalled some story I had read, the legend of the Arabian astrologer, about a fellow who dwelt in the interior of a pyramid. It was like that. You could not hear even the distant roar of an elevated train, or a cat in the backyards. At length, we lighted our cigars. Wonderful weeds bearing some strange cabalistic symbol upon their bands, such as I had never smoked, and sake placed the liquors upon the table and withdrew. Migraine was eyeing me in a friendly manner over his cigar. Good nature radiated from him. His grand dukedness, so to speak, had dropped off, and he seemed simply a jolly sort of a chap with a distinct taste for wines and cigars. I made up my mind that this was my chance to find out how he managed to pull off his tricks upon the stock market, when suddenly he interrupted my unasked question by saying quite naturally, "I'll tell you."